And at 5:30, police in Fort Wright are trying to find the person who spray painted a hateful message on the side of the house of a same-sex couple.
Our Mike Shell spoke with that couple and joins us live from Fort Wright to tell us more about how they're doing now.
Yeah, Elise Sebastian and Hannah Windhorn say that they actually feel sorry for the person who painted the message on their house. And they even encouraged their 11-year-old daughter, Catherine, to join in to tell us how it has affected them. Elise Sebastian says she went out to dinner in Covington with Hannah and Catherine on September 18th. They were only gone for a couple of hours. When they returned home, they saw the message spray painted on the side of their house.
Before Hannah could even pull into the driveway, I said, "Let me out, let me out. I have to get out. I have to see what happened." And so we got out and we noticed hell is real, spray painted on the side of the house.
Fort Wright city leaders came to the couple's defense at last week's meeting of city council.
I think what's happened is horrible. It's a deplorable act, cowardly act, I think, for someone to vandalize someone's property in this manner. And I think city council is extremely outraged that this crime occurred in the community.
And especially adjacent to our pride flag. So it was obviously targeted at that and trying to impose someone's religious beliefs on us, regardless of what we believe. And we're just trying to be here and live our lives.
Mayor David Hatter, a Fort Wright native, put out a lengthy statement to his staff, which read in part, "I can't emphasize enough how deplorable and loathsome I find this criminal behavior, and I am confident that you share my outrage, disgust, and deep concern over this matter."
Especially, to Catherine. So she was hard to calm for hours. I needed to stay with her just walking throughout our house, taking her up to her bedroom. She wanted me right there with her.
Mayor Hatter went on to tell his staff, "There is simply no place in Fort Wright, Kentucky, or anywhere else for this type of repugnant behavior that has occurred." Elise says her neighbors and her daughter pitched in to remove the graffiti from the side of her house.
It was like we power washed our bricks.
Yeah. I helped clean it off. I power washed it.
You did. You did an excellent job. Did you like doing that? Yeah. It felt powerful to be able to remove a message like that ourselves. The amount of kindness and generosity that we've seen, I'm so proud of us for standing up for ourselves.
Now, the city of Fort Wright adopted an official resolution condemning the person who painted the message. Fort Wright police are investigating. We are told that they have beefed up patrols in the area. We are live in Fort Wright. We'll send it back to you.
All right. Thank you, Mike.